This is Jim Emter, Van Onen Company, Alexandria, Minnesota, with the closing grain and livestock comments for July 26, 2018. Corn market on the day up 1 to 2.5, soybeans steady to mixed. Chicago wheat down 5 to 6, Kansas City down 5 to 6, Minneapolis down 1 to kind of steady there. So really looking at a market tone that was reversal action today. We started out very high with corn up 6, bean market up 20, and wheat market as high as 24 cents in Minneapolis wheat. And we reversed back to basically only 1 to 2 higher in corn, like we said. Bean market, you know, about 20 cents off the highs, and the wheat market 20 to 30 cents off the highs. So we're going to be left searching here a little bit tomorrow. Obviously, crop conditions and good developments, cooler weather. The negative tone, the bull tone, was obviously developments out of the EU, and sets the course for direction, at least that hopes that NAFTA and China can come to the table as well here. But we're still trying to get the details out of the EU and get all the facts in place. So we're kind of stuck here searching a little bit near the upper end of the range, and I think it's important that producers acknowledge that, hey, the price levels aren't all that bad here for both the corn and Minneapolis wheat, and the two markets that I think they can address and, you know, really do some things in front of harvest here, where we hear a lot of people dealing with storage issues and constraints due to the size of this crop. So be careful, be addressing these, and look to those carries. There's some great carries out there. Feeder cattle today down 140, live cattle down 140, hog market down 150 to 167.5. So we had some reversals both in the feeder cattle, live cattle, and hogs. We're kind of left reeling. For the hog market, not a great development. Wheats have got a bit more, weights have got a bit more current, which is encouraging to see, but this reversal action is not a good tone to today. The feeder cattle, live cattle market, I still see a healthy market in general there. I see this market trying to extend into new highs and succeeding in time as we work towards fall, but right now, a little setback shouldn't come as a surprise as strong as we've been. This has been Jim Emter, Van Onen Company, Alexandria, Minnesota. Trading in futures and options involves risk of loss and is not suitable for all producers. Past performance is not indicative of future results. This is a solicitation. Have a great afternoon.